So, we are Dirt Bike Annie. I am from Earth as well. And some years ago, we did this for not as many people. And it's funny, like, what sticks with you, Jeannie reminded me, she was like, that is not how it was, what I described, but in my mind, because I hate myself on some level, I'm like, people roll into town, pick up the local paper, and say, oh, what kind of write-up did we get? Did we get a write-up? Oh, we got a write-up in the paper. And it would be like, well, their latest release, backing vocals sound like the braying backup vocals. More like braying. That could be good, right? That's like, that could be read as good. And it was worse. Yeah, I know. But it just goes to show, you never know what you're doing 25 years ago. It's gonna matter. And I feel like it matters. It's great. It's great for me. It's great for everybody. It's great for all of you. I'm so happy. All right, let's do this.
This one's for Ian.
Yay! Thanks for stoking my ego, buddy.
I'm
records right there. This is so, you know.
It's so heavy, that means it's real.
We took an 18-year break. And for probably 13 of those years, I was trying to get this family reunion going. You know what I'm saying?
Thanks, Dirty.
Thanks to Chad Durkins and Wimsy Land. It finally happened in New York in June. And
where's Chad Durkins?
I was like, right there, like, yes, great, we did it, we're done. That's it, it's over. And then the next day, Tahoe Jeff was like, Ian's gonna call you. And the other thing that happened is there was this guy from Waterslide Records in Japan. He was on our show and he's like, do you guys wanna do a Japan tour?
Yeah! Do it!
Anyway, we're going to Japan. So we're still a band at least until the end of April.
I'm gonna pull down the curtain here. You're gonna see behind the curtain. What bands try to do, what all these bands have done, if you've noticed, they play song into song into song. It sounds so goddamn professional. I'm like, how are we gonna do that? We gotta sound this good. So we try to do it too. And Dan has an old man ache in his hand there, trying to get that worked out. So Mike started the drum intro, and I was like, oh, just keep playing the drum intro. They're not gonna know. The audience, they're not gonna know what's going on. They're not gonna notice that.
I got it too. I'm just pretending. Nothing hurts. Nothing. Not a thing.
Yeah. All right, we're gonna play one more song. One more song. And this is, like every band, I don't know, probably many of you are in bands and you know what I'm talking about, but even if you're not, whatever it is you've got that's like special, it comes, there's usually like a physical place that like it kind of came from that you might think of, like, oh, remember when that happened? When it started, when I started doing that, I was in my bedroom, I was in my garage, I was wherever. We were at this apartment called 88 Christopher Street, and it was in the West Village, New York City. And it's not there anymore, so don't go on a pilgrimage. You can't find it. Tore it down. It was disgusting. It was full of rats.
You can still see it on Google Maps.
Rats and Wesley Willis Pete there. And so it's a special place. But that was the place where Jeannie, you kind of made me. What'd you put up?
Oh, I made you put me in the
band. Yeah, she made me put her in the band. Because she sang. It was a good decision that she made me make.
I was like, why don't you just let me be in the band? And he was like, okay.
She sang backup vocals for a thing we recorded, and then when we heard it, it was like, that was it. That was Dirt by Gang. And that's where it happened. So this is 88 Christopher Street, which in hindsight, it's a lot to cram into a lyric, 88 Christopher Street, but we're gonna do it anyway.
Christopher's.